Hello quizzes, welcome to another video. Today, let's play, what is this called? Here on Artie's Amazing World, there are things that we see, feel, and even use but we're not sure what it's called. Let's test your knowledge in naming these common things. Do you love beer? Me too. What do you call the foam on top of it? Yes, it's called balm. What is a perfect partner of your beer? Pizza. When you open a box of pizza, you will see a miniature circular table like plastic in the middle. This is to keep the box top from sticking to the pizza toppings. What do you call this? It's a pizza tent or pizza saver. If you want to go more posh than just beer, might as well drink sparkling wine or champagne. Do you notice the metal wire that keeps the cork onto the bottle? This is called a graph. Morning is not complete without coffee. For to-go cups of coffee, what do you call the cardboard sleeve of it to protect your fingers from the hot cup? Correct, Zaf. For some, instead of coffee, they prefer juice in the morning. Bottled juices are practical for people on the go. Do you ever notice that in all bottled juices, water, or any beverage, the bottles are not completely full? There is a term for the empty space in the bottle from the level of the beverage up to the bottle top. What is it? It's called ullage. Speaking of mornings, it is very important that you eat fruits for breakfast. Do you ever notice that strips that comes out when you peel a banana? That is called phloem bundles. There are people that eat bananas with a fork. I don't know, maybe to bring out that inner classiness in you. I think. Anyway, do you know what the prongs of the fork are called? It's called tines. Of course, when you eat turkey during Thanksgiving, a fork is a must. Have you ever seen a live turkey? What do you call the floppy appendage that drapes on its beak? It's called a snood. Speaking of animals, what do you call whiskers on cats? It's called vibrissae. After eating, be sure to brush your teeth. What do you call that amount of toothpaste you put on your toothbrush? It is called nurdle. What do you call that plastic or metallic thing at the end of your shoelaces? Aglet. How about the loop in your belts to hold the end in place? Yes, it's keeper. Do you wear jeans? There are tiny metallic buttons in your jeans that were used as a reinforcements for your jeans, especially in the areas where the jeans would be easily ripped off. It is called rivets. In the winter, wearing a beanie can be comfortable. Do you know what that ball of yarn or wool on top of it? It's called a pom-pom hat or bobble or touri. It is just a decoration, but originally, they were used by French marines in the 18th century to protect their heads if it hits the ship's low ceiling. Are you familiar with Elton John's song, Little Dancer? Lisa Kudrow as Phoebe Buffay in Friends sang it with the lyrics, "Hold me closer, Tony Danza, instead of hold me closer, Little Dancer." What do you call lyrics that were misheard? Yes, mondegreen. When you go to a fast food, when you order food, it comes with tiny cups to which you can use to get your favorite condiments. What are these little cups called? They're called souffle cups. There are souffle cups that are microwavable. You may not care about what's in your microwave, but do you ever question what those black grating on microwave window? It prevents microwaves from escaping so your food will heat up well. It is called Faraday shield. All dresses, shirts, gowns, suits or whatever clothing that is, there is a part there where you need to put in your arm through it. There is a particular term for that. What is it? Arm sai, or it can be armhole. When you do a little construction, you use a hammer to drive in nails on wood. What do you call the other side of it which you use to pull out nails? Yes, it's a pin. Speaking of construction, what do you call the partitions in a single window panel? Yes, the wooden strips that separates the window frames. It's called muntins. How about that post at the end part of the stairs? It's called newel. I envy people with good handwriting. Mine is terrible. I'm not even a doctor. What do you call a very bad handwriting? It's called griffonage. Speaking of handwriting, what do you call the periods or dots in lowercase letters J and I? They're called tittle. Do you also know that those letters you write but are not pronounced anyway are the silent letters that are called what? Aphthongs. When you write and you wish to emphasize a question by like saying it out loud, what do you call that combination of a question mark and an exclamation point? That is the interrobang. If you're enjoying this video so far, please don't forget to like, share, and of course, subscribe. Let's continue. How about when you want to say bad words and all the profanities you can think of but couldn't do so? You use just about any symbol like this. What do you call this group of symbols to replace profanity? What the, you got it. It's Grawlix. When you write with a pencil, you notice that metal thing on top of your pencil which holds your eraser. What is it? That is called a ferrule. I hate math. That's my excuse in not knowing symbols. How about you? What do you call the symbol which means to divide? Yes, it's obolus. Since we're into symbols, do you know what the infinity symbol is called? It's lemniscate. If you call your brothers and sisters as your siblings, what do you call your nephews and nieces? I mean the more general term, not gender specific. They are called your nibblings. Let's go to body parts. What do you call the space in between your brows? It's called glabella. Just below your glabella, what do you call the space between your nostrils? It's called columella nasi. Below your columella nasi, what do you call that groove between your nose and the middle of your lips? That will be the philtrum. Look at your fingers and toes. What do you call the smallest ones? It's called minimus. Speaking of toes, is your second toe longer than your bigger toe next to it? There is a term for that. That is yes, it's called the Morton's toe. What do you call the space between your thumb and your forefingers? It's perlicue. Look at your fingers. What do you call that light crescent-shaped part of your fingernail? It's lunule or lunula. It's the enlargement of the man's breast due to hormone imbalance or hormone therapy. What is it? Gynecomastia. Well, it's the man boobs. How about that part of your back that is hard to reach when it's itchy? It's called acnestus. Do you know that sound your stomach makes when you're hungry? What is it? It's called wamble. These days, sleep is a luxury. That is why when we wake up in the morning to go to work or school but finding it so difficult to get out of bed, there is a name for that condition. Yes, dysarnia. Babies cry a lot. Do you know that there is a term for their very first cry upon their birth? It's called vagitis. Close your eyes. Cover it with your hands. Press your hand unto your eyes. Then open it. Do you see light that follows anywhere you look? Yes, it is called phosphenes. All of us have already suffered this at one time. When you have a nosebleed, what do we have in more scientific term? Yes, epistaxis. There is this trend in YouTube about eating a lot. They call it mukbang. Have you experienced eating too much to a point that you already feel sick? There is a term for that. It's crapulence. After a mukbang last night, it's time to go to the toilet to unload. Have you ever felt going to the toilet where you know you're already done since nothing is coming out already but it feels like you're not done yet? It's this feeling of incomplete defecation. What do you call this condition? This is called rectal tenesmus. Are you somewhat like Dora, who explores a lot? There is a term for people who loves to explore caves. They are called spelunkers. Maybe we can be spelunkers too. There are caves I know which are fun to explore. How about tomorrow or the day after tomorrow? What do you call that again, the day after tomorrow? It's overmorrow. To be a spelunker, you need good eyesight. If not, time to hit your local optometrist. They have this eye chart that they let you read to check your eyesight. What is the actual name for that? Yes, Snellen chart. I am just hoping it will not rain overmorrow because I just can't take the smell of the dry ground when suddenly showered with rain. There is a term for that smell. It's called petrichor. How many did you get? Please comment your score below. Also, please check out my other videos too, like the ones below.